is like the 26th of March, 9:30 at night. And as you can see, we're chisel plowing. I did probably, I don't know, quite a few passes across the field already, just to make sure things were actually going to work before I waste my time filming anything here. But yeah, we hauled manure on this field all winter long, well, until it was covered. We chopped corn silage off this in September, and we got a nice crust of froze on top. Like, look at my tire here, like, clean, pulling it like butter. It's actually working better than I thought it would. So we got like 20-30 acres to chisel, so I might just do it all tonight. I don't know,
I need to turn around.
Yeah, honestly, I wasn't expecting to be chisel plowing anytime soon, because it keeps raining and it's cloudy all the time, but I feel like it's early enough in the spring, and according to the forecast, we're going to get some more major freeze and thaws going on here in the next week, plus another inch and a half of rain, mid-late week, so I guess we're not really worried about doing damage, I guess, as you'd say with spring. I mean, the ground's wet, but you, of course, you're always going to have wet ground when you're doing tillage. I mean, it really isn't that bad. I'm turning around on the ends. I ain't hardly getting no mud on the tanks. And we're biting in good. So, of course, we got a crust on top that's froze in the last 2-3 hours. Because it's going to be like 15 degrees in the morning. So, I mean, I'm going 8 mile an hour right now. We got this tractor tuned to 240 now. And we are going to make it an 11 shank chisel plow. But we ain't going to do that till fall. So, I think it can handle 11 shank right now. But, yeah, freaking waterways up the ass here. Yeah, so like, probably tonight, tomorrow night, you could do tillage, and then it's going to warm back up again, and then get cold again, and then rain. So we're about in a perfect window here, I think, to get a little bit of spring chisel plowing on. Like, we would have done this in the fall, but we're not going to haul manure over chisel plow ground. It's just not good, especially when it's frozen. Like, here we're turning around on stuff that chisel plowed last year. You can see the dust. I mean, there ain't much, but the top, very top, is dry. So, yeah, back to work. So I got the first strip done. It says we got 11.3 acres that I actually painted. The first couple passes, I forgot to turn the paint on, so it's probably like 12 and a half, maybe. We'll show you the field shape here. The second half, I just drove myself. Like, there's too many twists and turns for auto steer, honestly, and then short rows at the end. So there's the start. Right there's where their helm bales are sitting, corn stalks. And there's all the short rows right in there I just did, and then there's the rest of the strip. Basically, the idea is this farm and contour here. But, yeah. Gives you an idea what this field looked like. There's a lot of short rows. You can see all the times I turned around right through there. So we're gonna go to the bottom strip now. That one's about the same size, a little smaller. Then we're gonna try some sod. I don't know if that'll work or not, but I'm ready to go all night if I have to. Well, we got another one done. About 10.7 acres here. We'll zoom out on that one. Kind of wish this thing's touchscreen, but it works. Looks like we're drunk farming, basically, with the contour. See, right here, there's a fence. That's why that's a straight line there. I don't know, I think it kind of looks cool. You can see where it all went. But I got the corn stalks done. Up north, we got just some end rows and shit to do, which are technically corn stalks, but we're not gonna do that until a lot later. But we just wanna get the main fields done. So I'm gonna go try the sod now. I don't know if that's gonna work or not. We haul manure on that. I got half the field chisel plowed in December, if you remember that video. And then we ran out of manure, but it's all covered. Everything's covered now. So it's almost 12:30, but we're just gonna keep on hammering down. Well, it's about 1 a.m. here. I did get to the sod field. I can pull it. It pulls pretty good most of the way across the field, but like where I'm at now, by the gate is two furrows. If I wanted to, I could suffer through it, but I'm not going to. It's not worth it. It's when you start breaking shit. This field leans towards the north, and I did another sod field over there that leans towards the south. That one pulled perfect. This one, on the other hand, no. The frost got back in deeper after it came out. So, it is what it is. So, let it cool down a little bit. I don't think it's really going to be that hot when it's like 20 degrees out, but park here in the shed and call it a day. It's like 1 a.m. I started at about 9 o'clock, so we've been going for 4 hours or something like that, but I did get over 20 some acres done. Like, this field's half done last fall, so there's really only like 6 here, and then that's about all we have to chisel plow, like I said. So I was hoping to get her done, but it's not worth the frozen ground. Maybe it'll get better in a couple days, I don't know. Then it'll be too muddy, so. Anyway, I'll just go to bed.